We've got Ben Shapiro from L.A. Hey, Ben, moments ago, the President of the United States tweeted this out. Lowest rated Oscars in history. Problem is, we don't have stars anymore. Except your president. Just kidding, of course. After last week where he made the joke about president for life, now he's got to say, I'm joking.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think that anything the president says is going to be taken as seriously as possible so long as it can hurt him by the media. But pretty good joke, Mr. President. I like that one. You know, obviously, the ratings at the Oscars were down again this year. They've been down for the last several years. And the reason is pretty simple. Hollywood, when they put what they think is the best of Hollywood on display, it's what they think spits the most in the eye of the common American. And so they haven't had a picture since 2004 that's won Best Picture that was in the top 10 at the box office. There's this great divide in Hollywood between the movies that actually earn money and movies that people want to see and the movies that Hollywood wants to show us that they make, the ones that they talk about at the actual cocktail parties that they do have out here. So the movie that'll win Best Picture is a movie about a person having sex with a fish, Grinding Nemo. That'll win Best Picture. But the movies that people actually want to see across the United States, those are the ones that maybe are nominated for a technical award. No wonder people aren't tuning in.
Right. And here's the thing, Ben. I guess it's always been the case, but I've never seen such a chasm between the two. It's like there's no movie even rooting for you. You could say, I was at the theater and I saw this. And they're so esoteric. They're so deep. I guess I'm too shallow to understand it. The other thing is that people bring up is that it's just too long. It's not entertaining. It's not interesting. All the conversation is stilted.
Yeah, there's no question that they should shorten the broadcast. But the truth is the broadcast has been really long, you know, as long as I've been watching
forever.
The Oscars. I didn't even watch it this year for the first time in forever, simply because, again, I was not interested in watching all these people who are sexually harassing and raping each other to lecture the rest of America on why our morality is deficient. Mm-hmm. And that's essentially what it turned into. And that's highly irritating, I think, to most Americans. And it should be. Again, this is Hollywood patting itself on the back at the same time that Hollywood is experiencing one of the greatest scandals that they've had in a century.
And then you've also got the fact that it was the third award show for movies in a row. You got the Golden Globe, you got SAG, and then you got this one. It's like, I think I'm awarded out.
I think that's true as well. And I think that there's also a cable cutting aspect here. There are a lot of people who are not as interested in watching the Oscars, and they can watch the clips later.
Yeah.
Right? If they want to watch your show live, it's because the news is live. You're watching the Oscars. You can pick up the results on Twitter, and then you can watch the clips later on somebody else's show.